Come and sit on the block or folded blanket. And just make yourself comfortable when you sit. Take a few deep breaths. Okay. Let's make ourselves very comfortable with the knees lower than the hips. And then lengthen from the base of the spine upwards, from the hips to your armpits. Inhale, lift your arms, take your shoulders back, and just relax. Relax your shoulder blades, flat on your upper back. Your hands somewhere on your thighs, thumb and finger connected. Let's check chin level, back of the head moving slightly back to elongate your neck. Close your eyes, bring your attention inwards, and we just take a few deep breaths. Inhaling deep into the abdomen, then middle chest, upper chest, and as you exhale, exaggerate, draw your tummy muscles in, exhale fully, and again, inhale, breathing deep, expand in all directions, and as you exhale, exaggerate, use your core muscles, squeeze your tummy muscles in, exhale fully, and so on. On your next exhale, I want you to think about your pelvic floor muscles. So as you start to exhale, squeeze your pelvic floor muscles and lift. And keep lifting your tummy muscles in and up. Exhale fully. And as you inhale, soften. And again, as you exhale, squeeze your pelvic floor muscles. Lift your tummy muscles up. And all the energy lifting up. And so on. Inhale, soften. Exhale, drawing all the energy from the base of the spine upwards to the crown of the head. I just want you to exaggerate your exhalations using your core muscles. Again, exhale, squeeze your pelvic floor muscles, tummy muscles in. Exhale, exhale, exhale. And so on. You can keep your eyes closed. And just focus on the flow of the energy, flow of the breath. The breath is deep and flowing. And as you keep in your breath, deep and flowing, remind yourself about your intention. We all have intentions. Your intention can be very small or very big. Your intention can be just for this yoga class, or for a day, for a few days ahead. And if you are in doubt, ask yourself, how you committed to yourself? How are you committed to your health? And find the inspiration in your answer. Keeping the breath deep, flowing through the rest of the practice. On your next inhale, open your eyes, relax your arms, relax your legs, just stretch your legs to the front, give your legs a little shake. Let's just shake the legs, relax, relax, relax. Okay, well done. And then come on your own fours and we do warm up. Okay, cut in the calf stretch. You have your hands beneath your shoulders, knees directly beneath the hips, toes under. As you inhale, lengthen, arms moving forward and you push the hips back. So you want to lengthen through the sides, and then soften between your shoulder blades. Inhale, look up. And as you exhale, next round, chin to your chest, tummy muscles in, exhale fully. Inhale, abdomen down. Lift your heart, lift your tailbone, look up. And again, exhale and round. Inhale, abdomen down, look up. And so on. Your breath is deep, flowing, and your movements gentle. Gentle movements. Noticing how you feel in your body. Where do you need a little bit more stretch? Somewhere you need a little bit more stability. Let's do another round. The cow stretch, and then the cat stretch, and then bring your back parallel to the floor in neutral position. Okay, before we come up to down facing dog, let's make more space. Either you move your hands forward or you move your knees back, more space between your hands and your knees. Lean back, lift your arms, or think about lifting the head of the arms, lifting your armpits, squeezing the shoulders at the back, and then come up with strong shoulders, strong arms. Squeeze your arms towards each other, squeeze your shoulders, come up to down facing dog and spot walk. Bend your right knee, then the left. Let's do this a few times. Lovely stretch for the back of the legs. Again, checking how you feel. Keeping your arms and your shoulders strong. Squeeze your hands, arms and your shoulders towards each other. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Pressing finger pads into the floor stronger and extending. Lovely, take another deep breath. And then come up high on your tiptoes, look between your hands, bend your knees, and walk towards your hands, into your forward bend. And make space between your feet, hips width apart or wider. Take one hand at the lower back and check which way the pelvis is tipping, forward or back, definitely forward. Bend your knees more if you need. So we want to keep lower back happy, comfortable. Squeeze the legs, hold your elbows if that's okay. And we're going to move from side to side, nice and gently. From side to side, stretching a little bit more around the lower back and the hips. If you can't straighten your legs completely with the back comfortable, please do. Okay, oh, keep your knees bent, absolutely fine for the first forward bend. Nice and gentle stretch. Start to warm up all the muscles to feel better in our back, in our body. Well done, and then come back to the middle. Don't rush to come up. Squeeze the legs, hands to the hips. Bend your knees slightly forward. Lift your elbows, shoulders, lift your chin, and come up with a straight back. Squeeze the legs, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze as you come up. And then exhale and relax your arms. And just roll your shoulders, soften your neck. Okay, great. And we stretch to the sides. So keep your feet parallel, hips width apart. Inhale, stretch your arms upwards. Hold your right wrist and lengthen. Just pull yourself up and then to the side. Press your feet into the floor stronger and stretch. You have lovely stretch. And breathe. Breathe deeply into that side of the rib cage. Well done. And if you're okay with this, bend your knees and step back with your right foot. I'm your mirror. Step back with your right foot and go even deeper into your side stretch. And again, big expansive inhalation, stretching the right side of the rib cage. That's nice, everyone. That's lovely. And then come back, exhale and relax. And just shake your arms, roll your shoulders, keep your neck soft. Okay, lovely. We're going to change the direction. Inhale, stretch. Hold your left wrist, lengthen, pull yourself up and then to the right. Take a moment here. Press your feet into the floor stronger, stretch, stretch. Breathe into your chest, expand now the left side of the rib cage. Breathe in deeply. Well done, and maybe step back with your left foot, bend your knees, keep your knees bent, that's easier. And stretch a little bit deeper. Okay, breathing deeply, expanding the rib cage, now on the left side. Brilliant, and then come back. Exhale, relax your arms, again, relax your arms and your shoulders, just roll, relax, relax. Okay, well done, watch me for a moment. So we're going to take a block for the next one, and this is your forward bend. It's also a nice stretch for the hamstrings, for the hips, for the whole back, and even for the shoulders. So watch me for a moment. You're going to bring the block just in front of you, with your feet very wide as you can, as wide as your feet, the closer to the floor. Okay, so it's easier to fold forward. So we're going to do this. demonstration. Squeezing the legs, pushing the hips back, you're going to fold forward, holding the block, and then you're going to move the block forward and forward and forward. And this is a lovely stretch. You're going to stay here for 5 breaths. We're going to work with the core muscles. On each exhale, you're going to squeeze your tummy muscles in and keep pushing the hips back. If you don't need the block, just move the block to the side and just hold the floor with your finger pads very lightly. And then hands beneath your hips. We're going to hold the shins, squeezing the legs, coming up. Okay, so let's do it together now. Take the block. Okay, the block just in front of you. It's nice to start with the block. Okay, and then you can just move it to the side if you don't need it. And take your feet very, very wide as you can go. Feet parallel, let's just check, okay, second toes parallel, the outer edges of the feet parallel. Take your hands to the hips, inhale, lengthen, exhale, squeeze the legs, push the hips back, fold forward, and then find the block and move the block forward. Walk forward, little by little, and the hips moving back a lot, so let's just push the hips back. Back and back and back, lengthen through your spine. If you're very, very tight on your hamstrings, just soften your knees, just bend your knees a little forward, and that's okay, don't worry. And keep drawing the legs towards the midline, the hips moving back. Check your core muscles as you exhale. Lift your tummy muscles up and push the hips a little bit more back. And again, inhale into your rib cage. Exhale, draw your tummy muscles in and push the hips back a little bit more. Soften between the shoulder blades. And again, inhale, expand in your rib cage. Exhale, draw your tummy muscles in and push the hips back. Perhaps twice more, just 2 deep breaths like so. Expanding. On the exhalation, contracting your core muscles and moving back, your hips moving back, and a good stretch. Lovely, lovely stretch. And then move your hands or the block beneath your face. Now look at your shins, hold your shins with your hands, squeeze the legs and slide your hands up the legs. Strong legs, squeeze, 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 come up, well done, and then zigzag your feet together, zigzag, 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 and give your legs a little shake, okay, well done, that was a very good stretch, and then come to the front of your mat, and we do salutation to the sun, the sequence from 12 postures, and I'm going to practice easier option or beginner's option for the first round. Please do follow me if you want to take it easy. For the second round, I'm going to do a little bit different, okay. Always adapting to your postures, always listening to your body. We just want to have a good stretch and not working through the pain. Okay, hands to your heart. Checking space between your feet. Now inhale, lift your sternum, keep your heart lifted. Exhale, relax your arms. Inhale, very gentle back bend or just reaching upwards. And as you exhale, forward bend, squeeze the legs. Bend your knees if you need. Now inhale, half forward bend, holding your shins or the floor. Exhale, squeeze the legs and bow. And again, inhale, half forward bend, back is flat. Exhale, squeeze the legs and bow. And we do it again, inhale, half forward bend. Exhale, squeeze the legs and bow a little deeper. Now move your hands by the side of your heels and step back with your right. Right foot back, high leg lunge or lower leg lunge. If you want to take it easy, knee down, squeeze the legs, lengthen the tailbone, lift your chest, take a deep breath. And then exhale, stepping back into the plank or half plank. Plank is straight legs or half plank, just with the knees down on the floor, listening to your body. Squeeze your arms, squeeze your shoulders, lift your tummy muscles, look straight, inhale. And as you exhale, lean forward, knees, elbows, or just bend your elbows, lie down on your tummy, and we're going to take a moment. Pointing your toes back, press your toenails into the floor, knees into the floor, lengthening the tailbone, and come up just halfway, halfway, softening the buttocks, just testing the water, how you feel, hips on the floor, shoulders lower, two double chin, look straight, inhale. And as you exhale, drag your hands back, stretch, 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 forward, shoulders lifted, Toes under, down facing dog, or come on your all fours first, and then down facing dog. Lift your hips high, press all finger parts into the floor and extend. Enjoy the stretch. All finger parts, the four corners of the hands pressing into the floor stronger and you're stretching back. Great stretch for the whole back of the body. On your next inhale, come up on your tiptoes, look between your hands, right leg up, step forward, or take it easy with your knees down and then right foot forward, helping with your hand is good. Okay, check in front knee above your front ankle, lift your chest, take a deep breath, and now maybe straighten your back leg. So you need to step forward now, keep your back leg working, tummy in, and step forward into your forward bend. Squeeze your legs. Check again, one hand on the back of the pelvis, check in which way the pelvis tipping forward or back. Definitely forward, bend your knees more if you need. And come up with the super strong legs. Squeeze the legs, press down with your feet, come up. Salute to the sun. Exhale, hands to your heart. Left side, inhale. Exhale. Inhale and stretch. Exhale, forward bend, strong legs, squeeze your legs, touch the floor or your shins. Inhale, half forward bend, holding the floor with the legs. Exhale, bow, hands by the side of your heels, left foot back. High leg lunge or lower leg lunge. Take a deep breath into your chest. And if you want to challenge the strength on your legs and the hips, squeeze the legs, lift your tummy muscles and see if you can let go of the floor. Or just lightly, lightly touching the floor. And then stepping back into the plank or half plank. Squeeze your arms and your shoulders. Lift your tummy muscles. Deep breath. We're going to stay for another deep breath. Well done. And then lean forward. Knees, elbows, or just bend your elbows. Lie down. Point your toes back. Come up to raised cobra. Pressing your whole legs into the floor. Lengthening the tailbone. And again, hips touching the floor. Shoulders lower. Double chin, maybe lift your chin a little. Inhale. And as you exhale, drag your hands back and keep lengthening, stretching, stretching forward. Shoulders lifted. Toes under, down facing dog. Or again, come on your all fours. And then down facing dog. Lift your hips. Stretch the stretch. And again, check in your hands. You don't want to stand on your wrists. Move more energy on your finger pads. Four corners of the hands and stretch back. Extend. Deep breathing, everyone. Great. On your next inhale, on your tiptoes, look between your hands. Left leg up. Step forward. See if you can step forward. Back where you started. Help with your hand if you need. Take a deep breath into your chest and check in your back leg. Super strong. Press your toes into the floor. Engage your core muscles and then step forward. Forward bend. Squeeze your legs. Press down with your feet. Come up standing. Inhale, lift. Salute into the sun. Exhale. Hands to your heart. Take a deep breath. And then relax your arms. Take your hands to the hips. And we're going to step back with the right. Right foot back. Big step. Big step back. We're going to practice Warrior One pose. So for Warrior One pose, you want to see space between your feet, hips width apart, and your back foot facing to the right, about 45 degrees to the right. Then you bend your front knee, checking the hips facing forward, squeeze the legs towards the midline, lengthening the tailbone, engaging the tummy muscles and stretch your arms. So this is, might be enough for you, just checking how you feel in your body. Back leg is very strong, lift your chest, lengthen away from the hips and then take your hands together at the back of your head. We do a little shoulder stretch. Lift your chin, lean back to your hands, open your chest, lift your chest. Think about inhaling into your sternum. Sternum is rising up. Well done. How's your back leg doing? Very strong. Press your heel into the floor, out of reach of your right foot down, breathing deeply. And have a nice stretch for the shoulders. Well done. Now inhale, stretch your arms upwards. Exhale, stretch forwards. Bring your hands to your front knee. Just hold your front knee and do your cow stretch. Remember what we did in the cow stretch? Lift your chest and lift your tailbone. So you're trying to create this curve from the lower back, lifting the tailbone and your chest. Take a moment. It's much easier for the lower back. Just to ease the lower back after strong warrior posture. And then look down, touch the floor on the inside of your left leg, if you can, and step back to down facing dog. And we're going to spot walk, bend your right knee, then the left. Let's do this a few times. Keeping your hips lifting high. Back is long and straight. Great, and then come up on your tiptoes. Look between your hands, we're going to change side. Right leg up, step forward. Helping with your hand is good if you stop somewhere between. Okay, and then looking at your left foot, and you want to hop to the left. Hop to the left, place your foot flat. With your hands, come up on your knees. We're going to think about the lower back. Hips facing forward. Let's lengthen the tailbone like you do the cat stretch. Tummy muscles in, and then stretch your arms upwards. Warrior one. Okay, double check your front knee. So you definitely see your front knee above your front ankle. Stretch, deep breath. Hands together at the back of your head. Lift your chin and lean back to your hands. You don't have to go far back. Keep your tummy muscles working. We want to support the lower back with the core muscles. Draw in, breathing deeply into your sternum. Sternum is lifting, expanding the chest, creating more space to breathe. Well done. On your next inhale, stretch your arms and let's stretch forward. Stretch, stretch, push the hips back. Now hold your front knee and do the cow stretch. Okay. Moving the groins back, lifting the tailbone and chest. Nice for the lower back. And then look down, touch the floor on the inside of your right leg and step back. And again, spot walk. Move your knees, move your legs, bend your right knee, then the left. Push the hips high as you can. Have a good stretch. And then come up on your tiptoes. Look between your hands, bend your knees and walk in. Walk towards your hands, into your forward bend. Squeeze your legs. Keep that energy in the legs. One hand at the lower back. Again, which way the pelvis tipping, forward or back? Definitely forward. Hands to the hips. Lift your elbows, shoulders lift your chin. Come up with a straight back and strong legs. Inhale. Exhale. And relax your arms. So just roll your shoulders, soften, closing up. Okay, great everyone. So now, take the block or the brick. So whatever you have at home, and you want to squeeze it between your inner thighs. Ideally, you want to have enough space between your inner thighs so you can see your feet parallel and the hips width apart. So this is what you want. If you don't have a brick like that, maybe you have blocks. Just make sure that it's enough space. For me, for example, this is not enough space. So I definitely need to use the brick. I know if you're very skinny on your legs, you might need to use the brick this way, just to create more space, hips width apart between your feet. This is what you want. And then you're going to come to the table or come to the wall. I'll show you what to do. So I'm going to squeeze this brick or the block between the inner thighs. I'm going to come to the wall and you're going to find the height of the hips on the wall. That this is where you're going to place your hands. So hands going like that, like for down facing dog, okay? And then I'm going to stand back. So I'm going to try to keep my back parallel to the floor. I start with my knees bent, squeeze in the block, and I'm going to move the block back using my inner thighs. Back and back and back. So a few deep breaths here, lovely stretch for the back and your shoulders. And then you bend your knees and you walk in. Little steps, and then stretch up. Okay, so let's try it together. Or you can place your hands on the table or on the back of the chair. Okay, so I'm going to come to the wall. So let's find that height of the hips and you're going to place your hands there or rest your hands on the table and you're going to move back. Squeeze the block with your inner thighs and move back. Until you feel that your back is parallel towards the floor, Okay, let's just check. And if you look at your ankle joints, you notice that your hips above your ankles. So this is what you want, the hips above your ankles. Press with your hands into the wall and stretch back. I'm going to even step back a little bit more. Okay, back is straight. Squeeze the legs. And you definitely don't want to round your back. Maybe let go with one hand and check the pelvis. Not rounded, the lower back is not rounded. And your back is straight. Breathing deeply. Press into the wall or into the support you're holding and push the hips back. And checking again your legs, still hugging the block. Hug the block, have a good stretch. Deep breathing. Check your core muscles. As you exhale, lift your tummy muscles. Squeeze, 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 lift your tummy muscles. Squeeze and push the hips back. Have a good stretch. This is a lovely stretch. For the back, for the shoulders, for the hips, your hamstrings. Well done. And now we're going to bend knees and little steps forward. Walk towards the wall or towards the table and then just stretch your arms up. Stretch your arms, lengths and wiggle from side to side. Okay, well done. That was a lovely stretch. And then exhale. Take the block and shake your legs. Okay, great. And you can do this stretch any time of the day when you feel, okay, I feel a bit tight on my hips or my shoulders tight. Just come to the wall or to the table. Imagine the block between your inner thighs. You don't have to have the block. And then you're just pushing the hips back. Okay, moving the block down. Okay, let's have a little drink. I definitely need a little sip of water. And then we sit on the floor. Let's sit from the spot, if this is okay for you. So stretch your arms in front, inhale, and as you exhale, we just go halfway. Moving halfway, and if you find, okay, this is a bit too much, you don't have to do this squat with your feet like so. You can do the chair pose. You can keep your feet parallel, hips width apart, and you can go this way, into the chair pose. Okay, so if you're happy to follow me for the squat, we do another round. For next round, lift your toes upwards. Inhale, and as you exhale again, moving the hips back, halfway or a little lower, listen to your body. You don't have to go very low. And then draw your tummy muscles up and come up again. Come up standing, okay, relax your arms. Next time, maybe you can go even lower. Inhale, toes up. Exhale, going halfway or a little lower. Or maybe all the way down, if you can. And then bring your hands together and with your elbows, take your knees wider apart. Okay, if you're in this posture, just keep your arms straight ahead. Okay, just stop here for a moment. And then you can get up anytime. If you're in the squat with me, you're going to try to sit from the squat down and hold the floor if you need. So holding the floor and then sitting on the floor or stretch your arms and sit down. So whatever is suitable for you. And then stretch your legs in front and give your legs a little shake. Just relax your legs. Shake, shake, shake the legs. Okay, well done. Find yourself a block and also find yourself a belt. So I have a belt here. Belt is very useful if you can't reach your hands behind. I'll just quickly show you the back. So how to use the belt at the back. So we're going to try to hold hands like so behind. Okay, if that doesn't work, belt on top of the shoulder, and then you just hold the belt behind, creating this good space. Okay, so and the block for you to sit on. Okay, let's sit on the block first. Yeah, and then we do a lovely stretch for the hips and the shoulders, and the stretch called the face of the cow. So that's an interesting name for the posture. Okay, let's take right foot in beneath your thigh. Okay, and the left foot outside of your right thigh. Okay, now, checking your knees. Are you okay with your knees? Ideally, you want to have your knees in line and you flex your feet to protect your knee joints. And if you feel, okay, this is not for you, so what you do, you just stretch one leg to the front and you take left leg on top. So you would have left leg on top if you do one leg. Just make sure it's comfortable for you. If this is completely not for you, I suggest sitting in cross-legged. So just sit in cross-legged, and this is also acceptable. Just keep adjusting. Okay, so I'm going to sit in this variation. So I'm quite happy here in my legs and my knees here. So, and I'm going to flex my feet. How are you sitting? Let's check the back. Are you sitting upright? Okay, we're going to stretch right arm. So we're going to the opposite, right arm up, left to the side. And we're going to connect hands behind, or we try to connect hands behind. Okay, if this is too difficult, belt, very useful. You just bring the belt on top of the shoulder and you hold the belt behind. Okay, and take a moment there. Okay, take a moment, check how you feel. Okay, we're going to work with the breath. I'm just going to drop my belt down. Have a good stretch here. Okay, folding this right arm forward. You're going to draw whole arm back into your shoulder joint. Now keep it there snugly. Lift your elbow on a straight line. Stretch, stretch, stretch. And squeeze your shoulders at the back. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And if you wish to close your eyes, you can close your eyes. Notice again your back. Breathing deep into the base of the spine. And as you exhale, squeeze your pelvic floor muscles in, tummy muscles in and up, drawing all the energy upwards again from the base of the spine to the crown of the head. And again, inhale, breathing deep into the base of the spine. And as you exhale, drawing all the energy upwards. Well done. Another 2 deep breath. Inhale deep. Exhale, squeeze your pelvic floor muscles, tummy muscles, lifting all the energy upwards. Brilliant. And then open your eyes, relax your arms. You just give them a little shake, roll the shoulders, relax your neck. If you have both legs crossed, like mine, so you can do this party trick. You look at your top leg and you go 360 degrees around. Okay, go around, turn on top of your feet, and then again sit on the block and see if it worked for you. If it didn't work for you, don't worry, we just change the cross of your legs. So you would change like so. You take one foot under your thigh, you take right foot outside of your left thigh, and you again flex your feet. That's nice stability, gives you nice stability for your knees. Ideally, you want your knees again in line. Now we're going to stretch left arm up, right to the side. Lengthen, keep your back straight, and then connect your hands at the back. Again, the belt, just bring the belt on top of the shoulder. Okay, and grab the belt behind. This is also nice. Keep adjusting. Take a moment. Fold your left arm forward, draw your whole arm back into your shoulder joint, keep it there snugly, and lift your elbow up and up and up on straight line. Well done. This armpit moving back, squeeze your shoulders at the back, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Softly close your eyes. And again, notice your back is straight. Keep sitting tall. Deep breathing, inhaling deep. Exhale fully. Inhaling deep into the base of the spine. And as you exhale, squeeze your pelvic floor muscles, your tummy muscles in. Exhale fully. You try to draw all the energy upwards. And again, exhale. Lift. Lengthen. You can imagine straight blue line from the base of the spine to the crown of the head. Okay, we have this main energy channel in yoga, we call it Sushumna. And try to draw all the energy upwards from the base of the spine upwards to the crown of the head. Well done. On your next inhale, open your eyes, Relax your arms. Give them a little shake. Roll your shoulders. Stretch your legs to the front. And also give your legs a little shake. Just relax. Relax, relax, relax your legs. Well done, everyone. And watch me for a second. So we're going to sit into the puppy pose. So it's something between the child pose and a downward facing dog. So it looks like that. You're going to walk your hands forward and the hips back at the same time. And you're going to soften between your shoulder blades. Lovely shoulder stretch here. Soften, soften, soften. Maybe your head can touch the floor. And you have a lovely stretch here. Okay, so let's come on all fours. Okay, come on all fours. Toes under, that gives you nice stability for your knees. And we're going to move hands forward. So the hands not beneath your shoulders. Your hands moving forward. So to give you a good stretch. So hands moving forward. And then you're moving the hips back closer to the heels. And I want you to soften between the shoulder blades. Soften, soften, soften. Maybe you can rest your head on the floor. You don't have to. Okay, have a good stretch. Soften and melt between the shoulder blades. Hips still moving back. This is a lovely stretch for the back, for the shoulders. And you try to draw the shoulder blades deeper into the upper back. You're sort of rolling the shoulder blades inwards, into the middle, into the center. And softening. Let's take another couple of deep breaths there in this lovely, gentle puppy pose. On your next inhale, lift your head and please lie down on your tummy. Lie down and bring your hands beneath your forehead. And this is your crocodile pose. So let's just wobble the buttocks, soften, soften, relax your lower back. Relax, relax, relax. And then inhale, lift your head and come on your elbows. This is your Sphinx pose. So I just press your legs into the floor, lengthen the tailbone, and look, watch the screen for a moment. So you are in this Sphinx pose, nice beginning of the back bend, nice back extension. So, and watch me for a second. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to come back again to this crocodile pose, and we're going to work on strengthening the core muscles and strengthening the back muscles. In this posture, we're going to lengthen the tailbone a lot until you feel your tummy muscles participating. This is your core muscles start to engage. And then you're just going to lift one leg and release. Then another leg and then release. We're going to repeat this 3 times. And then maybe you can lift your both legs up and then exhale and release. So let's, and then we do the same with the arms. Okay, so let's do the legs. So your hands beneath your forehead, your crocodile pose, rest your forehead there. Lengthen the tailbone so much that you feel your tummy muscles begin to lift the lower abdomen. So you feel this, those muscles start to participate. And lift your right leg up. Spread your toes and push the heel away from the hip. Stretch, stretch, stretch that right leg. And then exhale, bring it down. Left leg now. Inhale, lift your left leg. Yes, spread your toes, push the heel away from the hips, strong left leg and long left leg. Exhale, bring it down. And again, lengthening the tailbone, right leg. Couple of breaths, push your heel back, away from the hips, stretch, stretch, stretch. Exhale, down. Lengthening the tailbone, left leg, push the heel back, extend that left leg, strong left leg. Exhale, bring it down. And again, lengthening the tailbone, right leg. Push the heel back, flex your foot, spread your toes, toes active. Exhale, down. Left leg, lengthen the tailbone, lift your left leg, push the heel back, stretch, stretch, stretch. Well done. Exhale, bring it down. Okay, now take a moment, take a deep breath. So for the next round, we're going to try to lift both legs. Okay. Lengthening the tailbone again. And see if you can lift both legs. Push the heels back. Hold it. Hold and breathe. Hold and breathe. Exhale. Bring it down. Repeat twice more. And again, lengthen the tailbone. Lift your both legs, or if you feel it's too much, one leg is okay. Just lift one leg. Exhale, bring it down. Again, we're going to try again. Lengthen the tailbone, two legs or one leg. Make a choice. Lift, maybe two legs too much, do one. One is fine. Exhale, bring it down. Okay, wobble your buttocks. Just soften, soften, soften. Relax, relax, relax. Take a moment. Well done, everyone. And again, come back into your Sphinx. Elbows beneath your shoulders. Okay, watch me for a second. We're going to do almost the same with the arms. So we're going to do this. We're going to stretch one arm, another arm, three times. We're going, at the same time, you're going to look down beneath your face. And then we try to do both arms. Or just carry on with one arm. Don't worry to do everything. Okay, so let's try. So, arms, stretch your arms to the sides. Go on your finger pads, lift your elbows, and you draw your arms back into your shoulder joints. Squeeze your shoulders at the back, and I want you to think about your legs. Press your legs down, lengthen the tailbone, and we're going to lift your right hand off the floor. Inhale, and then bring it down. Okay, now looking at your left hand, inhale, lift. Exhale, bring it down. And again, press your legs down, lengthen the tailbone. Inhale, right. Exhale, down. Well done. Now left. Inhale, lift your left. Exhale, bring it down. Again, checking your legs and your back. Press your legs into the floor, especially your knees. Lengthen the tailbone. Right arm up. Exhale, bring it down. Okay, now left arm up. Exhale, bring it down. Well done. Now we're going to try to do both arms, but don't worry to do both. You can do just one at a time. And again, lengthening the tailbone, legs into the floor. Inhale, both hands over the floor, maybe, maybe not. Deep breath. Exhale, touch the floor. Great. We're going to try again, twice more, short hold. Again, lengthening the tailbone, press your knees into the floor. Inhale, hands off the floor. Exhale, bring it down. We do one more. Don't worry to do everything. And again, once more. Inhale. Well done. And then exhale, bring it down. Now, hands beneath your forehead. Again, wobble your buttocks. Soften, soften, soften. Relax, relax, relax. Well done, everyone. That was, I know, that was very strong posture. You have strong core muscles, strong back. Okay, we're going to come up on all fours now. Come on all fours. Remember this puppy pose. Let's do again, puppy pose. Toes under, walk your hands forward and your hips back. So let's stretch. Lengthen and stretch, lovely puppy pose. Pushing the hips back, your hands forward. Forehead may be touching the floor, maybe not, it doesn't matter. Stretch and lengthen, push the hips back, soften between the shoulder blades, roll the shoulder blades deeper into the upper back. Another two deep breaths. And then lift your head, move your hands closer to your knees and sit on the floor with your legs in front. Okay, so we worked lovely with the strong postures to strengthen the back and the core. And we're going to move now into the twist, just to ease the back. So you bend your right leg, take your right foot outside of your left leg and you hug your knee. Sit tall. Check if you need to sit on the block. If your pelvis is tipping back, that's not very nice. So you would either tip the pelvis forward and lengthen, or you sit on the block. Please do sit on the block or the brick if you need. You want to keep your back upright. So you would sit like so. So you're sitting on the block or the brick. And when you're going to move into the twist, So it's this way. So we're going to move like so. You will need another block or the brick for your hand, so you don't lose the length of your torso. Okay, so make sure that you have two blocks or block and a brick. Okay, let's try. Also, another option for you, if you want to lean to the left and take your left foot to the right, so see if this is suitable for you. Make sure that your left knee is happy with this. And you're not sitting on your heel, you're sitting on the floor or on the block. And let's stretch right arm. Inhale. Exhale, moving into the twist. Finger pads behind you, closer to your sacrum, either on the floor or on the block. Press into the floor and again lengthen. Keep the length. Exhale, tummy muscles in, and you take your shoulder back. Get a little bit more opening. On your next inhale, left arm stretch. See if you can hook your elbow over the knee. And again, inhale, lengthen. Exhale, tummy muscles in, moving deeper into your twist. And again, inhale, stretch. Exhale, tummy in, moving deeper into your twist. Let's check the neck, lift your chin, like drinking from the tall glass. Back of the head back. Neck is very comfortable. Let's take another deep breath. Inhale, you stretch. Exhale, moving deeper, maybe moving your hand around your hips a little bit more. Don't worry to go deep into your twist. Listen to your back. And then come back to the middle. Hug your front knee for a moment. Sit tall, shoulders back, back of the head back. Relax your neck. So if you have both legs crossed, again, this party cheek, again, the same party cheek, looking at your top leg, and go 360 degrees around, and you sit again. Okay, or just change the cross of your legs. So if you need, so follow me. You bend your left leg, you take your foot outside of your right leg, maybe lean to the side and take your right foot to the left, not sitting on the heel. Okay, take a moment here, again straighten, left arm, exhale, moving into the twist, hand closer to your sacrum, press into the floor and stretch. On your next inhale, right arm, stretch, hook your elbow and use the same breath. Inhale, you extend in. Exhale, tummy in, moving deeper into your twist. And again, inhale, you stretch and lengthen. Exhale, tummy in, moving deeper into your twist. Nice and easy. Working with the breath. And let's check the neck again. Check neck is comfortable, chin slightly lifted, head tilted back. Back is straight, creating this, again, straight line from the base of the spine upwards to the crown of the head. So try to keep the length, keep in the space. Well done, everyone. Another deep breath. And then come back. Come back, hug your front knee. Sit tall, take your shoulders back, take back of the head back. Relax your neck, relax and soften. Stretch your legs to the front. Give your legs a little shake. Shake, 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 and lie down for final relaxation. So final relaxation looks like that, your shavasana, when you've taken your feet wider than the hips. And then you tipping the pelvis forward. You have this lumbar space between the lower back and your yoga mat. You take your arms to the sides and relax, just closing your eyes, nothing to do, just be. Okay, I will be sitting for you and guiding you through your relaxation. Also, very good to have a drink before relaxing. Maybe have a drink, maybe put your socks on, jumpers on, grab the blanket, cover yourself with the blanket. Okay, I will be sitting for you and guiding you. So please do lie down. Relax. Take your feet wider than the hips. Press your hips into the floor stronger. Restore the lumbar space. And if you're not sure, take one hand at the lower back and just check in. Okay, there's a space between my lower back and yoga mat. Wiggle your shoulders, shoulder blades flat on the floor, arms away from your body, palms facing upwards, back of the head, nicely balanced on the floor. And if you're not sure, just roll your head from shoulder to shoulder, relaxing all neck muscles, and then come back to the middle, smile to relax your facial muscles, and leave the beginning of the smile on your face. Feel your forehead becoming wider and smoother. Relax your scalp. Relax your ears, the skin beneath your ears. Relax your eyes softly closed. Relax the back of your eyes, your upper palate, the base of the tongue, and the back of the throat. Slow down your breath. And just mentally scan your whole body from the crown of the head to the tips of your toes. Exhale and soften. Exhale and letting go of all the unnecessary tension. Noticing your grounding points, where your body touching the floor. And imagine that you can breathe into your grounding points. Softening, relaxing with each breath. Establish in your mind that it feels safe and secure, knowing that you're being supported by Mother Earth. Acknowledge that you're part of the great universe, only one little spark maybe, but nevertheless, one part of the big plan of life, important. Necessary, because you're part of the whole creation within it, not outside of it, and you're not alone. The rest of life is needing you just as much as you are needing it, and this binding together, this needing, sharing, caring, makes you feel secure and protected. Enjoy your breath. Now, as your relaxation and short meditation comes to the end, bring your awareness back to your surroundings, back to the room you are in, to your friends, to your family, to your pets next to you, and deepen your breath. Extend your inhalations, exhalations, reawakening the energy in your body. And then wiggle your toes and your fingers. Slide your legs together, arms by the side of your body. Inhale and stretch. Take your arms over the head. Stretch this stretch away from the waistline. And when you feel sufficiently stretched, bend your knees to your chest. Gently rock from side to side, just hugging your knees and rocking from side to side. And then roll over to your right hand side and come up to the sitting, and then sit comfortably for a moment with your hands in Ajna Mudra in front of your heart. Inhale, lift and lengthen. And as you exhale, slightly lean back just to feel strong support of your back muscles. Support steadiness of the universe. Close your eyes, reflect your practice, reflect your intention of the practice. Notice how you feel. Enjoy extra strength, flexibility, and clarity of mind. Traditionally, we finish class with one gentle om. Exhale first. Inhale. Om. Bow your head to your heart, to the light within you, and open your eyes. Well done, everyone. Thank you very much. Namaste. And have a lovely day. See you soon.